guys, today I am back again with another video, and in this video I'll be showing you guys how to make slime, how to make a squishy watermelon only using paper. Now, things you'll be needing is tape, you'll be needing scissors, you'll be needing markers of what you're doing. I'm doing watermelon, so I'm going to use those red, brown and green, and I'm using paper and cut up pieces of memory foam. You can use sponges or stuffing, but I just needed to use that. So first, what we have to do is we're going to get the paper and we're going to fold it, because we need two sides of it. And you want to fold it, and then you want to draw a watermelon. I'm just going to do a quick little watermelon because I need to really hurry up on this video. I'm just going to
hurry up.
I'm going to do an upside down watermelon because I found out that's kind of cute. I'm so sorry I have not been uploading in for like ages. It's because I stayed at my cousin's house and I was gonna make a video there, but I forgot to bring my camera, because now I use cameras to film, and I forgot to bring my camera and I forgot to bring my editing laptop, so it was all over the place and I could not use it. So sorry about that, I'm so sorry. Soon I will be having another giveaway, but that's going to be a surprise in a different video. I'm not going to announce it in this video because it's going to be a surprise for you guys. Well, obviously now it's not a surprise because you know that I'm going to have a giveaway, but you don't know what it's about. So I just keep on colouring it in because I wanted it to look really nice and like have no white spots, but I kind of tried to rush because I needed to hurry up because I didn't want to have this video for like ages, just me colouring it in for ages, you know. I don't like that sort of thing. I'm like, oh God, I'm gonna do this and I'm gonna do that, and then they just take forever to do it. So I just tried to hurry up on this. And I just used just cheap Crayola markers. I didn't use anything special really, and it's just simple, and I just really like this way because it's so simple and it's actually really slurizing. So I just keep on colouring it in, and I wanted to go for like the upside down watermelon. So that's what I just done an upside down watermelon, made it look cute, and just done that and coloured it in. I actually got a hand cramp because I've been colouring in for ages, but you know, it has to go like that. Well, I've only been colouring in for like 2 minutes and I had a hand cramp. I know, I'm so cringe. And then what I done is I just drew a little kawaii face, and it wasn't kawaii at all, so yeah.
It was actually creepy, but
I had to make it look cute, so I just tried to make it look cute, and then made these little pip seeds.
And I found it really cute
because it was a watermelon, and I love watermelons. So then what you have to do is you have to cut it out. So I'm just gonna
cut it out.
So then you're going to have two pieces like this. And it's okay if it isn't completely the same, but you just want to make it like this. Then all you have to do is just tape it up. So I'm just going to tape it up. But leave one side open so you can stuff your stuffing in. You can put whatever you want. I'm using little bits of memory foam, but you can use little bits of sponges, you can use little bits of stuffing, you can use whatever you like. Trust me on this one, guys. Trust me on this one.
So you just want to fold it inwards.
so everything is stuck in, and then so everything is all together, and then you can have a perfect opening bit so you can put in your stuffing. This is the time when you have to choose the bit that you want to leave open. I decided to leave the top open because I just find that I just wanted to leave the top open because it would just be easier if it was the top than the bottom, because the bottom was all curved and the top was straight. And if there's like little bits that can't fold in, just cut it a bit so it like folds. And I just rushed on this one, so, but you have to take time if you want to make it really good. And you want to tape it off everywhere except from where you want to leave it open to be stuck, because then all the stuffing will completely fall out and it will be the worst. Literally, it will just not be slow rising and it will be horrible. Trust me, it will be the worst. So now this is the part to take out what you're going to stuff it with. I decided to stuff it with bits of memory foam. But you can use bits of sponge, you can use stuffing, you can use a bag, you can use fabric, you can use whatever you want. Just make sure that it fits in perfectly, because if you add too much, it will eventually break. So all I did is just stuffed it in to make sure that it would go in properly. Okay, so now what I did is I just put the, I'm losing my words. You can tell it's Friday because I'm losing my words. So you want to stuff all the memory foam in. Don't stuff too much in or then it will not work. So just use the right amount that you would, that won't completely stuff it, or then it will just explode and it will pop and you won't have a squishy. I kind of rushed, so mine didn't look that good. But if you don't rush and you take your time, then it will look so good and it will be amazing. I wanted it to be like a fat, ripe one. That's why I made it like a bit like big. And as you can see, I ripped it because I accidentally put in too much memory foam. So now to make it slow rising, you want to completely cover it with tape. Because if it's just paper and just bits of tape, then it will not be good. Trust me, it will be so horrible. It will not rise, it will break. And, you know, you're not going to like it. So make sure you tape it up perfectly. And if you want, you don't have to use tape, but to, like, fold it in and stuff. You can use hot glue and then cover with tape, because you have to use paper and tape so it will work. But if you wanna make sure it completely like does not rip, you can use hot glue or you can use any kind of glue. And then you are finished. Now the more tape, the more slow rising. And yeah, and I really like this squishy. It was actually really slow rising. On camera, it didn't look that slow rising, but trust me, in real life, it is. And I forgot to color the back of it. So if you color it, then it will look way better. Mine actually broke because I stuffed it too much, but just don't stuff it that much and then it won't break. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe and comment down below if you want to see any more squishy videos like this. And just make sure you give this video a ginormous thumbs up. Bye guys!